Hi, good morning. I'm Dr. Sindhu Sastri, working as a professor at Department of Aeronautical Engineering, Institute of Aeronautical Engineering, Hyderabad. So today, I'm going to explain how to find the shear center of the open sections. So this one is the structures laboratory for aeronautical engineering students. So this one is equipment we are using, this one is the apparatus are using to find out what is the shear center, how to find out the shear center for these open sections. We know that open sections and closed sections. So here, as the open section, I have taken here is a C section here, channel section I have taken here. So what is the C section? Where the shear center is there, you have to find out the shear center. Why? Because, so for that, any member, if you load, what will happen? Bending will take place and twisting will take place. So, but for this aircraft construction, mostly we are using aluminum material. So these aluminum material, if you are not loaded properly, what will happen? Both bending and shear stresses will be developed. Twisting is also taking place. So because of the twisting, shear stress will be developed. So this aluminum material is very weak in to withstand for that shear stresses. That's why we have to avoid that shear stresses. So then where if you apply the load, there will be only bending will be there. There is no shear. So that point you have to find out. So that point is called shear center. Shear center means what is that? At that particular load, at particular place, only bending will take place. There is no twisting. That point is called shear center. So that we have to find out where is the shear center for the different cross sections of the beams, cross sections of the open section beams. So this one is C section you have taken or channel section you have taken. Like that, different cross sections. T section will be there, I section will be there, and L section will be there. So these are all open sections. So for that open sections, we have to find out where is the shear center. So here see, you have taken this one is channel section. So these channel section attached like this, we are fixed here like that. So now this end is fixed. One end is fixed here, other end is free. So at free end, we have to apply the load. Now suppose if you apply the load like this or like this, what will happen? So because at this position, here there is no material. Here material is there, here material is there, here material is there. This load will transfer through this one only, like this only. So the load transfer will not take place like this. So that's why what will happen, both the twisting and bending will take place. Suppose if you apply the load like that, so if you apply the load like this, what will happen, what should happen like that? So if it is a all four sides material is there, then exactly it will bend like this, it will bend like this. But this direction, there is this side, there is no material. Even though if you apply the load exactly at centroid of the member, so it will not bend like this. So twisting is also taking place. How to find out whether this beam is bending or twisting, or both bending and twisting is taking place? So for that, very important is here one plate, horizontal plate you have attached here at this free end, and here these two knobs are there here. So this for these two knobs, we have attached one dial gauges here. So these are the two dial gauges. So I have fixed here, dial gauges fixed properly here, and now this one I am making is a 0 0. Here is 0, this one is also 0. We are taking like this, and then we have to apply the load. Here see some teeth is there like this. So why? Because we have to apply the loads here. So each one is 5 mm, each one is 5 mm. Now exactly you are taking the scale please. Now see here, this is scale. If you, this is one side here like this. So from here I transfer this one like that, exactly value to this one transferred. So this one exactly at this particular point. So this one is attached to the hanger here. So on that hanger you have to put the weights. Before that, once again you take this one, is take it to the origin 0 0. Now this one weights, each weight is 10 grams. This one, each weight is 10 grams. I have taken 30 here, 2 3, total 30 is there. So this 30, it is giving 600 grams. So this is 600 grams. Attaching to this hanger like that. Now see, if the both the dial gauges if showing same reading, then the beam is bending is taking place, there is no twisting. But here see, this one is 8.86, this one is 1.00. So it means this one is deflected more. This end is deflected more, this end is deflected less. So it means this beam, it is twisting is taking place like that. Both twisting and deflection, deflected and twisted. So now where if you apply at this particular point and both the reading should be same. Now what have to do? Slowly you have to move towards this direction. So it means we have to find out what is the distance from that web at how much distance the centroid is shear center is there. So slowly you have to adjust this one like this, 5 mm or more left side like this. Slowly move towards this direction. Now here still it is 100 and this one is 85, so still twisting is taking place, still twisting is taking place, and one is showing 1.00 and second one is showing 0.85 mm deflection. Now slowly I'm moving towards left direction. Moving slowly. Now see, at this particular point, approximately that is 1.02, this one is 1.01. So it means here there is no twist, so only bending is taking place. So at this particular point, so it means from here to here, how much distance it is, this point is there, just according to the, with the help of the scale, you have to measure it and then you have to find out the shear center distance. So, and after that, we have to substitute in our equation and then we have to find out what is the shear center distance like this. So, this one slowly you have to move towards this direction and where the twisting is not taking place. It means, so both the dial gauges, it should show the same reading. So that one is called, that point is shear center. So that point you have to measure here from here to here. So what is the distance is there from here, this web to this this one. Here each one is 5 mm, from here to here is 5 mm. So you have to measure it and you can find out what is the shear center for this channel section. So this one is the experiment. Like that you have to repeat with the different loads. So this one is taken with 600 mm, like that 500 mm we can take it, 800 mm we can take it, 1000 grams also you can take it. So based on that one, where the sheets and how it is changing from one point to other point, you can observe it and you can draw the graphs so that, so for that particular load, these are the sheets, and for this particular load, like this. So where, how it is changing, everything you can find out by using this apparatus. Okay, thank you very much.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.